morning, everyone. Welcome to worship this morning. We're going to start things off with a song that hopefully will get you up and moving around. It is God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen, We Three Kings. We'll have the words up on the screen and sing along with us.
Gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember, Christ our Savior was born upon this day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Shepherds brought tidings of the same. Now that in Bethlehem is born the Son of God by name. Those tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Those tidings of comfort and joy.
People of God, welcome to worship. I'm Jay Hilbinger, one of the pastors here at First Lutheran Church. Whether you are taking part live with us now as we're recording or later on by way of video, thank you for being here. We appreciate the gift of your presence. Please take some time to greet one another by making comments on Facebook and welcome your fellow worshipers. A couple of announcements as we begin. We will celebrate Holy Communion. I've got my bread and wine set up right here, and we will take part through our online worship today. So if you've got bread and wine or grape juice handy, please have that ready to go. Today at 10 a.m., we are starting something new for the next 3 weeks, including today, and that is our Advent Coffee Hour. The Advent Coffee Hour will be on Zoom, And you can see Thursday's e-news for each week's topic and also the link to click on so you can be a part of that Zoom conversation. It's basically just like we do during our normal coffee time here through Zoom, just a way to connect and see one another that we haven't been able to catch up with in a while. So you and your household can catch up with your church family that you haven't been together with for some time. A couple other things to be aware of in this special season. Advent devotions are available. They're out by the main office entrance, that's Office A, on a table outside under the overhang, and you can pick those up. We've got devotions for Advent called Prepare Ye that are based on psalms and hymns. We've also got an Advent calendar from the women of the church. Please come by and pick those up. And something else we're doing this year, we've got our First Lutheran Church Christmas ornament, Christmas tree ornament for 2020. It's a slice from a tree, and it's decorated on one side with a message from First Lutheran Church, and then on the other side, we encourage you to decorate it and make it your own as a family or as an individual. So come by and pick those up. They're also outside the office under on the table under the overhang near the office entrance, entrance A. A few other things. Next Sunday, December 13th, is our annual Lessons and Carols Sunday for both worship styles and services at 9 a.m. Contemporary and 11 a.m. Traditional. And many people say it's the best sermon of the year because there isn't one, but we'll let you decide. Anyway, lots of wonderful music as we celebrate our Lessons and Carols next Sunday at both services, 9 and 11 o'clock. And then also next Sunday, December 13th, will be our second attempt at drive-through communion. We had great turnout and went very well last month in November. So December 13th from 2 to 3 in the afternoon next Sunday, drive-through communion. And we ask that you please also bring food for our annual Meals at the Manger collection so we can continue to help those who are food insecure among our local neighbors. Thanks for doing that. So let me invite children to come a little closer. This is the children's time. It's the lighting of the Advent wreath. We want everyone to pay attention and listen in while the Gwenzy Still family leads us in the lighting of the Advent wreath.
Consider all the forms angels take in Bible stories. Sometimes angels appear in dreams or vision, even while the recipient sleeps. Other angels are radiant, shining like bright lights. Some appear as winged spiritual beings who appear suddenly, then fly back to heaven. Some angels look like ordinary strangers. Recipients think they are travelers who just happened to cross their paths. In rare cases, natural phenomena like the star that guided the Magi are angel messengers. We light our second candle, recognize God's messengers appear in many different forms and circumstances.
The point is clear. God uses all of us in different ways and in varying circumstances to make God's message of good news real in people's lives. Take a moment to think of someone or something that has revealed God's good news of love to you. Now, say a silent prayer of thanks. Take another moment to think of someone in your life who really needs some good news, who really needs to be loved this week.
Now say a silent prayer for them and then make a plan to help them.
Merry Christmas!
That's great. Thanks to the Gwenzy Still family for those wishes and reading this morning around the Advent wreath. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, angels bring messages from you, and sometimes we may not be looking for them or even wanting them. Your messages can be challenging. Your messages can be hard to hear. They may send us off in a new direction. And your messages can also contain hope and promise and love when we need it most. So God, let us be on the lookout for the angels in our lives and be thankful. And let us also make ourselves available to be your angels for others. We give ourselves to you in this time of worship and ask that you continue to work your Advent blessings upon us as we continue the journey with you and with each other. Amen. Let's enjoy together our next song.
On the nights when the dark lasts a little bit longer, when the wind and the storm is a little bit stronger, when the fear in my heart dips a little bit deeper, when my faith to stand gets a little bit weaker, where could I run to? Where could I go? Even when it feels like my world is shaking, even when I'm at all that I can take, no, never let me go. Whoa. Even when the waters won't stop rising, even when I'm caught in the dead of night, no,
reading for this second Sunday of Advent is about the encounter that Joseph has with an angel while he sleeps before the birth of Jesus. Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 25. The birth of Jesus the Christ took place like this. His mother, Mary, was engaged to Joseph. Before they lived together, she found out she was pregnant with a child from the Holy Spirit. Joseph, being a God-honoring man, decided to part with her quietly in order to spare her any public disgrace. Just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of God appeared in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to get married. Mary's pregnancy is the work of God's Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will heal God's people from their sinful ways. This would fulfill the prophet's message. Look, a virgin will conceive and bear a son. They will name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke up in the morning, he did exactly as the angel commanded in his dream. He took Mary as his wife, but did not consummate the marriage with her until she gave birth to the child. They named him Jesus. Well, as we have said, and as you know, our Advent worship series is about how God shows up in our lives through encounters with angels. I happened to witness an angel encounter on Friday. It happened in Gibsonville, just northeast of Greensboro, so I have to tell you about it this morning. I pulled into Peace Lutheran Church, the parking lot, at 12:46 to conduct a graveside burial at 1 o'clock for one of our dear First Lutheran Church members, Bob Johannesson, who died last week. As I got out of my car to walk around the church building to the cemetery, a man pulled in and rolled down his window and spoke. He asked me, "Is this Bobby Johannesson's funeral?" "Well, yes," I replied. "It was for family only, and I assumed he was part of the family." As I walked to the graveside, he caught up with me and started talking, asking a few questions. He told me that his name was Wilson. I found out he had gone to school with Bob Johannesson from kindergarten through 12th grade. And he just happened to be driving by the church that day, and he saw the funeral in the cemetery and thought maybe, he wondered, was it for Bob? Just then, I was greeted by the funeral home staff who were there to assist the family. And then I turned and spoke with the family for a moment, and by then it was time to begin. The stranger from the parking lot just kind of filled in behind the seats where all the family were seated and stood at a safe social distance. The service lasted about 25 minutes, and there wasn't any music, of course. It was all spoken. And there were about 15 family members present. As I concluded and started to walk away from the space, the man from the parking lot announced, "Pastor, would it be all right if I sang something as we conclude?" Which took me by surprise, and without me having the time to answer or even ask the family or anything, he began to sing. And he sang the chorus to, "I need thee every hour. I need thee, oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, our Savior. I come to thee." It was absolutely beautiful. Angelic, you might say. He sang in perfect pitch. And when he finished, there were smiles on most of the faces. And the others had tears of joy and of being touched. And there were several amens when he concluded, including my own. Nobody had invited him. No one knew he was coming. None of the family even knew who he was. And he just happened to be driving by. But he delivered a powerful blessing from God to all of us who were gathered there, who were there to grieve and to give thanks for Bob Johannesson. Angels are messengers of God. Sometimes they glow brightly in biblical stories or in our own experiences with bright, brilliant light and heavenly bodies with wings. Sometimes they are ordinary strangers who cross our path with absolutely no warning. Sometimes they show up in our dreams. They are unexpected. They surprise us. And they come to offer a blessing of some sort, even though sometimes that word may not feel like a blessing. It may feel like a difficult challenge. And other times it is easily discernible as a word of hope and promise and help. In our reading today, we hear the story of an angel appearing to Joseph in a dream while he sleeps. And we can relate so well to Joseph in our current day experiences. Life as we know it is a lot like Joseph's own life back then. You might say Joseph had a plan and Joseph had a dream for how life would unfold. He was about to get married to his fiancée Mary. They would build a life together, they would build a home together, and they would start a family together. But quite suddenly, that plan was destroyed. His dream was shattered, and Mary turns up pregnant. And worse yet, Joseph knows the child is not his own. It is in this moment, with hopes dashed, feeling also, Joseph feeling fully the weight of the social pressure in how to part with Mary appropriately, that Joseph has a bizarre dream. An angel reveals that God has a different plan. We may even say a bigger dream. One that can turn this unholy nightmare for Joseph into a means of blessing and purpose. And here's the thing. We don't want to make light of this decision and pretend like it was an easy decision to make. Oh, an angel showed up. Yeah, I'd listen too. It was a dream in his sleep. And you and I have had plenty of dreams, and some of those we may or may not discern a message from. And Joseph had a very difficult decision to make. He could choose what might seem obvious and let fear be his motive and yield to the social pressure of what everyone would agree was absolutely in his best interest for the sake of his future, his well-being, his vocational well-being as well, and economic well-being, as well as his reputation and his family name. He could choose fear as his motive and pay attention to what was appropriate to do in such circumstances. Or he could choose faith as his motive. He could dare to believe in this new dream of God that was larger than himself, for the sake of pregnant Mary, for the sake of this unborn fatherless child, and for the sake of people beyond himself whom he would never meet, including us. When hopes are dashed, when life takes an unexpected turn, and when plans melt in the cauldron of reality, do we trust a God who really is about resurrection, who creates divine possibility in the midst of our despair? And can we trust God enough to choose faith over fear? Maybe the key is looking more closely, paying more attention, trying to be aware of the angels that God puts in our path. Because a lot of times they don't look like angels. Not what we would think or call angels. Well, many of you know our beloved Pastor Emeritus, Pastor Brady Faggart, who died last Sunday evening. He served this congregation for over 18 years, and his legacy continues to live in countless ways in our community life together. He was also my mentor, and he was the first pastor who asked me over lunch at UNCG one day, "Have you ever thought about becoming a pastor?" He helped guide me in choosing this vocation. But after seminary, after graduation, after receiving my first call, I was about 15 months into my first call as a pastor, and I was ready to give up. I was ready to quit. I was miserable. I was not enjoying my chosen profession. And I couldn't see any way out of the rut that I was in. I was stuck. Over the course of several weeks, I had lengthy conversations with two of my mentors, Pastor Brady and Charles Newman, who was a pastoral counselor that I had worked with one summer during seminary. They became my angels in that circumstance. They spoke a blessing I was not expecting, and they also, through that blessing, offered me a challenge. After lengthy conversations with them both, I realized why I was not enjoying being a pastor. It seems like, and the best way I can say it is this, I was spending all my time trying to figure out who the congregation wanted me to be in order to serve them as their pastor. And I remember a phone call with Pastor Brady when he said these exact words, and it was almost identical to what Charles Newman said to me as well when he offered me advice. Pastor Brady said, "Jay, remember something. Remember this. God called Jay Hilbinger to be a pastor. He did not call Jay Hilbinger to become someone else in order to be a pastor." It was both a blessing, good news, and a challenge. I had to shift my perspective, and I also had to trust that God knew what God was doing. It is something that I have always admired about Pastor Brady, something this congregation has benefited from immensely over the years. Brady always tried to discern as best he could what God wanted for himself, for his ministry, and for the people he served. And then he spoke from and acted from those convictions. He did not let the fear of the status quo guide his journey or affect that voice of God within him. And he did not try to give in to the fear of dissenting opinions that might try to sway his convictions. His advice to me in my second year of being a pastor is something I will always remember. He helped me get out of that rut that I wasn't sure I'd ever get out of. So as our Advent journey continues, let's think about this story where Joseph has a dream. Let's think about the angels who have blessed our lives with a word of hope, a word of promise, and perhaps a challenging word in the midst of life's shattered plans and broken dreams. Let's also pay attention to anyone in our lives who needs a word of promise or hope as well, as we try to be those angels for each other and for God's world. Who might be the next surprise visitor that we weren't expecting to cross our path? They may just have a word that will help us, like Joseph, to choose faith instead of fear. In Jesus' name, amen.
Please join us in singing Hope Now.
Thank you.
sets me free.
It's the time of the service when we normally receive an offering, and today as we think about that, I'd like you to think about what offering you can give to our neighbors who are in need during this special season. I want to first of all thank you for supporting our annual Angel Tree collection. We had over 110 gifts that were collected for local families and are now being distributed, so thank you for that offering of gifts for our families in the community who need it. Other ways to help local and global families dealing with poverty, hunger, and homelessness are in our Thursday e-news. Honor cards are available for Habitat, Gum, Out of the Garden, and the IRC, and they're available through December 9th through our website. So look at the e-news from Thursday to connect with that. Our annual Hugs collection is underway. Hats, underwear, gloves, and socks, you can drop those off at entrance A near the office, at the office entrance. Our gum blessing bag collection is also underway. That's at entrance A also. And the ELCA Good Gifts Catalog is a great way to give gifts for people who really don't need more stuff. And everybody could benefit from being honored with a gift that will make a difference locally and globally to address poverty, hunger, and homelessness. So use the ELCA Good Gifts Catalog that is available through our e-news link and also at elca.org. Well, as we continue, let us now be God's prayerful people. Let's honestly share with God our journey as we share it with one another and know that we, in sharing, connect with God through each other as we pray. Let us pray. O God of Advent surprises, we thank you for the angels in our lives who show up to reveal a message of hope or a message of purpose or a word of promise. May we, like Joseph, look and listen for the ways you reveal your dream to us and how we can take part in helping you fulfill your dream for the world. Lord of the journey, show us the way. Faithful God, ever-present Spirit, we know so well what it feels like when our plans fall apart and when our dreams are ruined. Give us the courage of Joseph to trust you more rather than to fear the circumstances, and certainly rather than to fear the opinions of others. Use us to continue to bring Christ's love to our neighbors. Lord of the journey, show us the way. O Creator God, source of life, as the seasons change, as autumn harvest gives way to winter dormancy, we see your creation teaching us grief, teaching us patience, teaching us renewal, teaching us rest. Make us good and faithful students of these rhythms and faithful caretakers of this precious earth we call home. Lord of the journey,
show us the way.
Gracious God, there are people on our hearts and minds this day we wish to pray for, people who have made their needs known to us. We want to give thanks for loved ones who have recently died, including Bob and Pastor Brady. We thank you for their faith, for their love, and their lives. We pray that you comfort their families and friends with the promise of resurrection hope. Lord of the journey,
show us the way.
And gracious God, we lift up to you these others whose names are known to us. So we pray for Matt, Christine, Howard, Evelyn, Catherine, Grace, Larry, B, Melissa, Nan, Bob, Hank, Rita, Chris, Karen, Laura, Matthew, Henry, Carter, Isaac, Bill, Hope, George, Cheryl, Arthur, Laura, and Bob. And gracious God, there are other people on our hearts and minds this day we wish to pray for. We take a moment now to name them before you as we speak their names silently or aloud. Lord, may they know your presence, your love, your healing, and your comfort. And may we share in being that presence for them. Lord of the journey, show us the way. All these things we pray, trusting that Jesus continues to lead us even today in our lives as we pray the words he taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. As a way of being nourished in our journey together, we celebrate a meal together now. Holy Communion. Take some time to grab something at home, bread and wine or grape juice, as we give thanks for this special way in which God makes presence known. Blessed are you, our breath of peace, our giver of life, our source of love. Your song of wisdom rang out before the world began. Your dance of grace inspires all creation. You have filled us with hope for a better world, where those considered last are first, where violence is overcome by love, and where all work together for justice and peace. You send prophets to awaken us to your advent presence among us, and you bring our deepest longings to birth.
As we watch for your coming among us, we proclaim your eternal goodness.
On the night before Jesus died, he showed your Advent presence among them as they enjoyed a meal together. Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and shared it among them, saying, "Take and eat. Whenever you do this, remember me." After supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and shared it among them, saying, "This is God's new covenant with you. Whenever you do this, remember me." God of hope,
make this bread the means of our nourishment, this wine the sign of God's transformation, this table the foundation of our renewal, and this community the place of our rebirth.
Amen. So hear these words of good news for you. Perhaps they are angelic words to your ears today. Given in love for you. Given in love for you. Amen. Join with me for a blessing and the last song. As we go about our week, may we be inspired by the trusting faith of Joseph, who put God's agenda ahead of public opinion and above his own reputation. Like Mary and Joseph, let's see the children in our world as the work of God's Spirit among us. A baby is God's opinion that the world should go on. Children are living messages we send to a time we will not see.
Let us make sacrifices today so that the world's children have a better tomorrow.
And the child shall be called Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Amen.
Join us in singing, O Come, Emmanuel.
Rejoice, rejoice, of David, come and open wide thy heavenly home. Make safe the way that leads on high, and close the path to misery. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
Emmanuel, God is with us. Thank you for being a part of worship. Now go with Christ and go as Christ to love and serve God's world.
Thanks be to God.